Let's now bring in political analyst, attorney Michael Yusinko, for his thoughts on the president's visit to the U.S. Attorney Mike, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Ron. Thank you for having me.
Nice to have you again in the program. Now, we have U.S. President Biden again assuring the country's defense commitment to the Philippines is ironclad. But this is something we've already heard from his defense officials, from his national security officials. This time, why did he have to do it personally, face-to-face with President Marcos? Is this really more of an assurance from them for us, or is this any kind of signal to China?
It could be both. No, if we put ourselves in the shoes of the United States, you have to recognize that they are trying to regain some of the foothold that they had in our region. No? So, if you recall, prior to this state visit of our president, the President Biden also hosted the president of South Korea, mm-hmm. and the prime minister of Japan. So just reading those events together, we can deduce that it is certainly, or the U.S. is certainly exerting more effort this time around to consolidate once more their influence in our region. So to answer your question, maybe it could be both, no? It could be both for really consolidating their influence and also to give really stronger assurances to us, our country, that they will fulfill their treaty obligation or defense treaty obligation to us when that need arises.
And it could also be a rekindling of that friendship that the U.S. didn't have with the Philippines in the previous administration, right?
It could be. It certainly could be, no? But you can also flip that coin to the other side, no? It's also about us, meaning our president, you know, trying to correct what has been done in the past, no? That the past administration has chosen to ignore or to set aside, quote unquote, our alliance with the United States, and this our president now is trying to remedy that by also assuring the United States, President Biden, that we are still strong allies.
Now, we'll be gaining from this visit, of course, and of course from that personal assurance from President Biden. But at what possible cost do you think there will be repercussions from this meeting coming from Beijing?
Well, certainly we know that China has reacted quite negatively to what our president has been doing, not just this visit, no? So mm-hmm. that's a given. That's a given, no? Because the U.S. and China are in a tight race to be the top dog in our region. So a negative or an aggressive reaction from China should be expected. So our concern, no, as citizens of the Philippines, our concern should be how our government would react to those negative reactions coming from China. Mm-hmm. So how our national security officials, our president himself, how he would respond to these negative reactions coming from Beijing. That is what should concern us, no? Rather than what China will say, okay, or what the foreign secretary would say.
And speaking of that, now President Marcos is working on a delicate balance here while asking for and getting support from the U.S., but while carefully not wanting to provoke or antagonize China. Do you think he's doing this tightrope well right now?
As of now, I would say yes. No, I think from what he's saying and from what his government is saying, I think he's maintaining the balance well for now. The situation is so fluid, Ron, that we cannot say with certainty that tomorrow or the next day that balance will still be maintained. No, but right now, we can see that the president and his team are keeping their nerve. No, they're staying steadfast with their line of saying that whatever we are doing now is mainly and principally to boost the national defense capability of our country. No? Now, having recognizing that the U.S. and the China have their own rivalry going on, the president has wisely chosen to at least say that we are adopting the neutral position. But we are not, of course, forgetting that we also need to protect our national interest, to protect our national territory, and that we are doing everything that we can to ensure that.
Political analyst, Attorney Mike Yusinko. Attorney Mike, always a pleasure having you on the program. Thanks.
Thank you, Ron.